Fantastic. Hello there! Master Hellish here and welcome back to my Planet Coaster Let's Play, where here we are in Outer Time Park, looking over Courthouse Square in, I think, 1955 it was. We have our park over in the background, our starter park, our profit park, which is actually making some profit. Over the course of last episode, where I was putting this square in as a kind of foundation of what of things to do next, we accumulated $33,000, which is absolutely fantastic. Now, this episode, I wanted to put in a ride that came down the street, hit 88 miles an hour with a bolt of lightning and left a pair of fire trails. And I was going to call it 88 or something like that. The problem is we can't do that. Because we simply don't have a ride which can do it. We've got track rides, but they're all like kind of slow things. They're just powered cars or water rides. And then in the coasters, all we have is ones with chain lifts or with friction wheel lifts. We've got no like kind of accelerator track, something that will get it to go really fast. I'm not entirely sure there's one of them in the game, so that's something I'm going to have to look at between now and next time before I decide to do this. The other thing that I wanted to do was to put the courthouse in. Now, I've already built a courthouse in one of my episodes, back when I was looking at the early access of this game. The only problem is that when I go to my blueprints, I'm fairly sure that one of these two is it, but it won't let me import it because it's not enough. I don't have the parts. The parts haven't been researched. So I need to research rides, I need to research parts to do anything that I want to do, really. So what we're going to do today is we're going to do a couple of things. We're going to connect this up with our starter park so people can come over. I think we're going to move the carousel and put it in the middle of this park here. I think it might be a nice thing to have. Maybe the circus is in town and they've brought a carousel as well, popped it in the middle of the town or something like that, or maybe there's a fair in town, they've popped it there. We're not going to be able to build this exactly like it is in the film, otherwise we're not going to be able to have rides, and that's kind of the point. So we'll do that. But the main thing I wanted to do today is build the corner coffee shop. Now, in this era that we're working with, it's Lou that owns the coffee shop, as far as I believe. And it's quite a simple thing, I think. So we're going to give it a go. Now, first things first, let's get this connected up. So paths, and for now, we're just going to do a nice, simple straight line into the area. And then what we'll do is we'll kind of just bend it into, oh, there we are, the middle of the T-junction. We can maybe put an alleyway there where people can come in and out. Perhaps we can connect it to the end of these roads here in the future. Not in the future of the trilogy, but in the future of this series. But for now, I think that will do. So let's get this merry-go-round carousel thing. What's it called? Hello? You are a carousel. Right, okay. So let's stop the carousel. We're going to close it down. I'm sorry, everybody. Get off. Get off. There we go. They all got off. Look at them in a massive bunch there. I'm sorry. I need this. I'm going to go put it in down here. So let's see. I kind of want it in this space here. I thought it would look quite nice. I don't want the path to connect there. I know I can change that later, but let's rotate it round. Oh, yes. Hang on. Let's give it a precise rotation and put it right up against it. Come on. Just another pixel. There we go. Fantastic. Let's move the entrance round here. We'll make a little queue. There's a little bit of a hill there that I put in last time. Let's tell you what. Let's just flatten that off. Flatten to foundation. Just make our queue nice and flat. Queue area. It's not costing us a lot of money, a few cents here and there. Brilliant. Okay, now let's put the queue in. Let's do just a standard concrete one, I think, would be best. So let's go straight down here. Doesn't have to be very big. We don't want it to be very big. I don't want this to be very imposing. Let's go. There we go. We're not going to do priority pass anymore for this one. Disable the priority pass and let's open it. Where's the open button? Oh, of course it's there. Ta-da! Cracking! Okay, so let's see what that looks like. Yeah, it's not too imposing in the middle of the square. You still get an idea of how the paths are supposed to be. I'm not sure about this queue. Maybe bend it round here. I'll tell you what, let's change the queue. It won't let me change the queue. Hang on a second. You. And I want to change the path. Okay, close. Can I now change the path? Yes, okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to put... Oh, hang on a minute. Q. There we go. So I wanted to just take this end bit off, bend it round sooner, and just kind of like... do that. There we go. I'm happy with that now. Hey, it's open again! Right, so we've connected it up, we've put a carousel in. I think it's now time to get on with the main thing for today, and that's this calf. Now, the first thing I'm going to work on is the outer wall, and then we'll do the inside, because I actually want people to be able to go inside. I don't know whether I'm going to put the roof on or not, we'll see. So let's go into scenery, and let's go building, custom. Walls. Let's have a look, see what walls we've got so far. So we've got kind of like big bricky blocky walls. No, that's no good. We've got windows. That could be good. In fact, we'll probably use a couple of these because we do need some big windows. We've got white walls, brick walls, which I think will be good for the upper story. Wooden walls, which are useless to us right now. Oh, what are these? Okay. So we've got these kind of container, what is it, painted wooden batten walls. Okay, they're not really much good at the moment. More woody things. Yeah, I don't think any of the existing walls are going to be what we're after. So what we're going to have to do... It's also going to be difficult to get the paths in and put the benches how I want them. Because I kind of want a plaza. Then I don't want it to connect up here. Oh, this is going to be really difficult. Let's think about the paths first. So let's put a flooring in, and let's select the grid to be with this. So if I put that there and there, oh good, it doesn't necessarily join up. Oh, it does now. Why does it join up there but not here? I don't want it to join up. And why does it not join up there? Well, that doesn't make any sense. Well, I know this place is an L shape, so perhaps we can leave a gap? I don't really want to have to leave a gap. Maybe if I press... Ooh, what happened there? I managed to put it in the air. Maybe if I press a button, it won't connect up. Alt. No, it doesn't like that. Is there something in the options and settings that I can do? Path supports. Curbs on path? Oh, wow. We've got curbless paths. Well, that's what I want. I don't want curbs. There we go. Let's get rid of that. Start again. Let's have a look. Curbs on path, no. Railings on... ground queue, yes. Railings and elevated. Railings on. So there isn't really an option, I don't think, to your square edges. Oh, nice! Square edged path. So you can do a plazery type thing. Now, see, that's joining up. I don't want it to. Um think I'm going to have to look at this. One moment. Okay, so I figured out what it was doing. What it was is that because there is a path junction here, it can't then connect up a square junction there nice and neatly, so it just doesn't do it. So what I've done is I've hidden a path just here. You can see that there's the curb turns around and it actually comes and connects up here. There's a path just there. And that means that when I place this square, it doesn't connect up to the path next to it. So I've just got to do that. And then I'm thinking this path here, if I delete this path, then I'm sorted. Job's a good un. The only problem is I'm not sure how I'm going to get it to connect up over here. I actually want it to connect up at this entrance. So I might have to redo this yet. We'll see. But using that technique, I can actually make these not match up and keep the paths nice and separate so I can do the inside. So that is going to be kind of like the inside pathway. I'll finish that a little bit more in a bit. But I want to be able to fit like benches on there. So if I do just a standard, I think maybe the sci-fi bench. Now, can I rotate that? Yes, but it does snap quite a lot. There's an angle snap on there, but I don't want it to. Tell you what, maybe if I put it in like this and we use the advanced move on it. No, not the duplicate. Advanced move. Move, there we go. Oh, no, you can't. Oh, there we are. There's advanced move. There's an option here. Is it X? I want to do an advanced move game. And I don't want it to snap to the side. Because I want to put like kind of like rows of benches in and a counter. Looks like something else I've got to figure out how to do. Okay, so with a bit of fiddling around, I can get rows of benches in. That's all right. Many guests are thirsty. I'm building a shop where they can drink stuff, all right? The only thing now is, so we've got an inside path where people can walk. We've got benches, well, we will have benches. I'll put a counter along here, and that'll be part of where you buy the food. So what we'll do is we'll do shops and facilities, custom, and we'll go like the milkshakes like this. And I think it'll just let me put it in, I'm not sure. No, I'll have to connect it like right up here. So it's going to be a bit weird to have it like that. There's not really much else we can do. I'll put some toilets inside here as well. So if I rotate that round, we'll have some loos down here at the end. There was a phone booth at the end. We'll have an ATM in there as well at some point. So we'll have milkshakes and things. Yeah, I kind of wanted it to be an open top counter, but that's the closest we can do. So we got the inside roughly kind of like the right size and shape that we want. I would like this probably to be a little bit thinner. So if we go paths, select grid, and we're actually using this corner piece here as the grid. I can't make this any thinner without making it too thin for people to walk down. So we'll leave it as it is. And I need to now fix this bit. I need to get this kind of like connected. So I'm thinking, let's see what I can do with the paths. So if we do this, that's good. And then these ones here need reconnecting. So natural, I think it was that one. So that's connected there, I think. Is that connected already? It is now. Where is it? I don't know. And then we need this to connect up somehow. So I don't know. Like, do we do a wider path? Like, kind of like this? That's obstructed. Okay, maybe not that wide. Okay, so we can kind of do a path as an entrance. To try and keep it as even as possible. Come on. Looks like getting this to connect up is going to be difficult. Okay, I think I can work with that. Because then we can put like some tables or a machine or something in here. Actually, ooh. There we go. Oh, that'll do. That's close enough. Brilliant. Okay, now let's work on the external walls. So for the external walls, we're going to go to buildings and we're going to use... Scenery. We're going to use these art shapes. And this is the only way I can think of building this, which would actually kind of work. Unless we've got some thinner pieces. So we've got various different cubes and blocks. I think I can get this to how I need it to be. There's no big flat ones though, like upright flat ones, I don't think. We've just got squares and cones. Let's make this bigger so we can see what our options are. I can rotate these as well, can't I? Oh god, we don't need extra large. Right, so what I need is like a strip along the bottom. Yeah, that'll do. Okay, so let's put that in and move it. So we need it upright. Let's angle snap that. Okay, let's cancel. Then move it. Put angle snap on first. There we go. Now we know it's going to be upright. Bring it over onto its side. Bring it up. Let's put it down so it just touches the ground. And then bring it to the side. That will probably just about do it. So we need a load of them all in a long line. I'm going to leave a gap at the front here because we're going to have like an angled bit where the entrance is. So let's say that's right. Now let's duplicate that. Oh no, now I've got to try and get these in a perfect line, haven't I? And a perfect... it's actually a little bit easier than I thought it would be. Control D. There you go. I just realised that these are all the wrong colour. It's like a mint green, the front of the place. Oh, that's perfect. I think. See this one? Oh, no, this is where we now get to see the different sections that I've put in because they're not all perfectly aligned. But to be honest, it doesn't really matter too much. I think that's going to be fine. Oh my goodness, this build's going to take longer than I thought. Okay, let's do a bit of time-lapsing on the walls. then. So I've been working on these walls for a little while now. It's taken me just over half an hour. I've got the upper floor brick walls in. I'm quite happy with them. The windows are very similar to what they are in the film. There's a canopy here. It's not exactly the same shape and colour, but it's more or less is right. This corner piece should be brick, but I couldn't find a brick bit that I was happy with. So I felt that the shape of this one much more was appropriate to what I was doing. So I've put that there, and I've put a piece on the far end to kind of mimic it, kind of mirror it, and to give it the same sort of feel. Over here, there should be a curved piece, but to be honest, there aren't any crescent sections in the scenery section. Well, they've got these pieces. Oh, no. Oh, technically I can do it. Oh, I better do it. Right, I think I've got it. I think all I need to do is rotate this piece round and then just slide it into position. I'm gonna make sure I get that bit right there. So I think that looks good. Let's bring it this way. Oh, hang on, it needs to come down a bit. To there, I think. Yeah, now the problem with this is the curve is just too big. Oh, I'm going to need the smaller piece, aren't I? Well, this is looking better. Let's just make sure... Oh, God, we're way off. Way off. Let's go... The problem with moving everything that's all the same colour, it gets very difficult to actually... see whether you've got something in line or not. You end up relying on the shadows. Okay, let's pull that to here. That's still too high, isn't it? You know what? That is... technically too small. But I think that's the best I can do, because... this is the medium, and it's too big. Because look, if I line that up to the bottom there... I suppose I could just do a bigger curve at the bottom than at the top. Well, let's try that. A bigger curve at the bottom than at the top. So, medium, put it down. There we go. Cancel out of this screen so we can see what we're doing. Set the colour. Go into advanced movements. Rotate it so that it is in the right orientation. Then move it so that we link up here perfectly, and then bring it up. You know what? I think that's probably a good plan. Are they lined up properly? More or less. So what we're going to do is we're going to do the same. We're just going to move this one now back a bit so it lines up. And I think up a bit. No, we'll bring it there. So it's not a complete semicircle, but it is a nice little curve. The only problem is now I need something to fill in that gap as well. Ugh. There we go. Well, that was actually easier than I was expecting it to be. Ah, yeah, that's better. Now, the only problem is I've got to do all this on this side. And then I've got to go inside and actually do the build. Oh, my goodness. This is going to have to be two episodes. All right, then. It's going to have to be two. Fine. We're going to do some time lapses and some other things and some more editing in future episodes. But this is like the first proper... Oh, this is awesome. Oh, I actually... Yeah, I kind of recognize this from the film. I like it. Let's go to blueprints. What I did is I saved the shot front. Oh my goodness, it saved more the front of the shop than I thought it did. I didn't want all that. Okay. Delete. Undo. There we go. I just want these bits. So I kind of just want from here. Can I select multiple pieces? Yes. So I just kind of... I mean, we don't want that extension there, do we? Yeah, we do actually. Oh, this is complicated. This is quite complicated. Tell you what we'll do is we'll put the whole top beam in, because that way we know like the kind of lengths that we're working with. And oh no, I deselected it. Let's try again. Okay, so let's put the top beam in first, separate, I think. So that's the back. That would be the front. So that's... Oh, hang on, there's one missing here, I think. Is there one missing? No, I don't think so. It's hard to tell. Yes, there was. Right, let's do that. So in theory, this should now, if I rotate it round... Oh! We see, this is what I was wondering. We've got one short on here. We need to move... Let's edit this building. Let's move this piece along and this piece along. We've actually got, let's duplicate that piece. We're missing a section, we were, and duplicate that window. There we go. I didn't have it correct. Now it's correct. Brilliant. Let's get that blueprint in, pop it here. Now we get the height right. So to get the height right, we compare it against the existing one. Close enough. And then the way that it matches up on this side is that only just overlaps by like a quarter of a brick. So we want it overlapping, and we need it rotating around again. There we go. Overlapping by about a quarter of a brick this way, kind of like that. And then forward, so it just seems to pop into the path, but not. There. Look at that. Cracking. Now, I'm going to have to manually build the curve, I think, because... Well, not, I suppose I don't have to manually build the curve, because it's just the other way around. So I, in theory, can select that. Let's do manual selection. That, and this. And just put that at the end. Cool! Now it's going to take some tweaking to make it look right, but we need to get this kind of... hang on a minute. If I put it like here, I can press X, which will allow me to do the movement. So think if we push it back so it's like that, that's exactly how we had it there. This was only just hidden, like only just by just a couple of pixels, and I've already got the height right. So that's it, that is in place. Now I'll have to do a bit of adjustments around here, because this is actually the back, this is what was the front. So now to actually have all that in line, I think this is the only piece that's not correct, that and the top curve. So if I just bring it out, come on, out you come. There we go. And we do this one too. These RBG arrows are interesting. Come on, just where I want it. There. That's better. Right, I'm going to fill this last little bit in, and then we'll take a look at how we're getting on. Okay, folks, so I've been working on it a little bit, and here it is. So, I finished this side, like I was planning there, and I also did a little bit at the front here. I added these front columns and the top bit there, so there's the main entrance. There is actually normally a door set here, but we're not going to put doors in so people can easily get in and out of there. So overall, I think that's the outside done. So that's going to be the end of part one. Join me for part two, where we'll do the inside, and if we've got time, we'll do a few more things around the park. My hope is to, in each episode, either do a whole thing or a part of a thing, but at the same time we're still gonna do tweaks and extra little things, like put the carousel in and a few more trees and the odd little bench. We're not just gonna concentrate on doing one old thing. We'll develop the whole park. So I am really, really happy with this. This is exactly what I was hoping to set out to achieve, and I've pretty much managed it. So I'm going to just put myself in a position roughly about, let's see, we're going to cross the road, let's get lower down a little bit, there we go, we're going to put ourselves here, and we're going to compare it to what it looks like in the film. So here's my reference picture. Now you can see that the windows are slightly spaced out differently, the sign isn't exactly the same. The proportions are a little bit different, but I felt that these proportions that I used were a little bit better for the park that we were doing. Also, the lamppost isn't in exactly the same place, but again, the lampposts have been placed nicely spaced out for park purposes. So overall, I think it matches up quite well. The colour may be a little bit too bright on the green side of things, but it is pretty close. I haven't got any words across the top there. You've seen the reference picture, there's coffee, sandwiches and so forth, soda and that. I don't know if I'll put them on, but I think by the time we've got the inside built, I'll put the roof on between episodes. I think we're going to be pretty good. So I'm very happy with that. If you've enjoyed the episode, remember to give it a like if you'd like to see more of this and you're not already subscribe to me, please consider doing so, and I will see you soon. Remember, you can check out extra videos in the links in the credits, and I will see you next episode where we will finish Lou's Diner. Thanks for watching, goodbye.